Hey folks, it's Frithgar here. How you doing? I went and had a little play around with some of this stuff for building, and part of the sidewall has come out of that tower. I have sort of figured out some of it, slotting these things together. It is a little time consuming, but I'm slowly getting the hang of it, and I wasn't very impressed with it yesterday because of how we weren't able to put all of our bits and pieces inside the castle that we were building. But I've sort of been playing around some more, and I'm starting to become more impressed with it. It just takes a little sort of bit of practice. And something that I didn't realise, which I've just sort of found out by playing around here on my own, is if you do two jumps while you're running along, you flip. And you do it with whatever character you're riding or playing with. Now, I've been having a think, and what I'm thinking is we've got a few things that we're going to do. We're going to unlock several of these characters, and we're going to customize our model so that we have the perfect model. I'm not quite sure how we're going to do it yet, but we're not doing that today. That is going to be in another episode. I still got lots of exploring to do and lots of things that I want to find. And again, that's going to be other episodes. I won't be exploring this world very much. I'm going to tower straight through wall. I'm going to do a building episode today, and then I'm going to do a bit more exploring, and I'll do that in other worlds so that we can sort of find, because there's so much more stuff to sort of discover yet. We got loads of stuff that we need to unlock. I know for a fact that there is a bazooka, and I really want a bazooka because that would just be epically cool. Okay, a bazooka. How awesome would that be? So I'm going to clear out a little bit more. We're going to level this off a bit more because we want to sort of do a spooky graveyard type thing. And I know we got all bright, colourful grass everywhere at the moment. I'm thinking I will recolour this to something else a little bit more spooky. So we've come out round here. I want to dig it off back over towards this tree a bit. And what I'm doing is I'm making it perfectly level for all of this. And we can always change it a bit afterwards if we really want to, but I don't think we will. I think I will end up leaving it just like this. I don't think that the terrain thing will affect the tree up there. I hope it doesn't. We'll find out in a minute. Because I will... I've just got a little bit more to do just over to here. That's about all we're going to do, I think. It's about that far. Let's have a... Can we look up? I don't know if we can look up. Yes, we can. We can go up like this. Now, is it affecting the tree? Yes, it is. It's actually cutting out the tree as well. That's a bit of a shame, because I wanted to... Yeah, it's completely demolishing the tree above it. That's not the greatest. Never mind. Let's pull this out. A little bit more here. And the controls still work for moving up and down and flying and so on when you're in this mode. They just seem to respond a bit more sluggishly, a bit slowly. So let's just move this over here. Get this piece out along here. And then I'm going to build a bit more of the castle walls. I'm going to extend those out a bit. That's going to raise up the ground around there. I'll extend out the castle walls along the front. And then this back piece here, this is going to be the bit that we... Right, smooth. I need to smooth it off now. This sort of levels the sides in a bit. And seems to attack the tree as well. We'll try and leave the tree alone if we can. Move this over this way. Let's come out here. Yeah, so the smoothing works really well. It just sort of blends in the edges a bit. Makes it look a little bit more natural, which I quite like. I like that effect. And we'll do the same over here. So that looks like a more natural slope coming up through. And all across here. And then we need to decide what colour we're going to do the terrain around here. Bring that over like that. I think we'll... No, actually, that's fine. That can stay like that. There we go. Come that out there. I blend in this top piece as well. I already did a little bit of this. Sort of played around with it a bit. See what sort of effects that we could get from it. Right, that's looking better. Now, if we just put in a bit of paint, we need to decide what sort of terrain we want. We've got sand, grass, because you can do it all the same colour if you want to. But I don't want to do that. I want to get a dark stone, basalt. I want a grass, I think. snowy, foliage dry, snow, sand, rusty sand. Oh, I see, that's rusty. Actually, that might look pretty good. No, we want a darker grass. That's normal grass, dry grass. Is that the one we want? No, that's too bright. That's way too bright. We might end up having to... If we do stone... Yeah, we'll do stone, I think. And then we can put in a little bit of... A few patches of grass while we're at it. So, if we come over this way... Just come up to the edge of it. I don't want to do all of those towers. I don't want to spoil the look of them. I work quite hard getting those in place. Alright, let's bring those out. I see the smooth tool. When you use a smooth tool, it also removes all the studs from the surface. So I'm not sure how I feel about that, because I kind of wanted to keep some of those on there. Let's put a bit of stone over here. We'll get rid of some of these models that are sticking up here, I think. There we go. It doesn't actually... It's pretty quick painting it. Once you've decided how you want it to look, it is pretty quick getting it done, getting the job finished. There we go. Right. Now, we could put in... What does foliage look like? Oh, that's just a... That might be the one we want. So we'll put in a few sort of bits of grass here and there. And we'll come in through like this. And we want it random looking. We want to do a random looking approach to this. Come in over here. A blotch over here like this. Maybe a bit more there. There, I think that's looking pretty good. Another bit over there somewhere. There we go. And we want a little bit of dirty rust. Is that what? No. We don't want that. Mud. No, the problem with mud is it's too squelchy, isn't it? We want rusty dirt. No. Dark red sand. Darker red sand. Oh, good grief, no. Definitely don't want that. Chalk. No. Dark wood. Wood. Sponge cake. Strawberry jam. Right, well, we don't want red licorice, strawberry jam, and stuff like that in... Oh, ice, no. Dark stone. Cave stone. Stone. All right, we'll put in a couple patches of darker stone, I think. Cover up some of this. Put a few of these in like this. There we go. A bit over there. A bit more here. There. Right, I think that's enough painting. Now I want to go to... Not the brick building. I want to go back to these builds here. And I want the wall. Now I'm going to try and build the wall on this way a little bit. Now this was the tricky bit. This is the one that I was having a lot of trouble with. I spent a long time playing around with this after my last episode to try and get it right. And I gotta say, it is quite tricky getting it to snap together. And hopefully in the future they will add a feature which will just snap the items one to another. If you get them wrong, they float in the air, they do all sorts of weird things. And look, see, that's not quite lined up, so I'm gonna have to undo that one. And then... Okay, I sort of glitched and then bugged out of the game then, so let's carry on where we left off. I'm trying to get a wall to stick onto here. So if I zoom right in, I want to move up this way. There. So you've got to sort of line it up just right. Now, I think we lined it up on that one last time. Is that going to be in the right place, or is that going to need moving over? Oh, actually, I think we got that one right this time. Yes, perfect. Look at that. Just in the right spot. It can be, once you sort of get the hang of it, it kind of clips together quite well. And I have been finding, if I do it like that, so that it looks like it's in the right spot, he says, I was finding that if I did it like that, it looked like it was in the right spot, it was actually in the wrong spot. But now it looks like it's actually going to work as it's supposed to. So we'll drop that one in there. Yes, perfect. Look at that. So now we're talking. Now we're getting somewhere. So we're going to bring out this wall. I think we'll bring it out another couple, and then we'll put another corner piece on. Although I'm not quite sure how we're going to finish the end of it. So we'll put that one on there. It'll clip in together. There we go. So it's clipping quite nicely now. Once you get the hang of it, because this is a lot trickier than Minecraft to get the hang of the building. Because Minecraft, it's literally just a block. And you can either put the block there, or you can put the block next to where the block goes. These, because you got so much more scope to sort of move stuff around, it's obviously going to be a little bit more tricky and open to making tiny little mistakes. And those tiny little mistakes, as we noticed yesterday, can easily frustrate. So let's move over this way a bit. And we want to get a tower, I think. Now we've got a tower corner. Tower ruin. Oh yeah, maybe we could do like a ruin tower on the end. Would that work? I don't know if that's going to work. Let's have a look. We can turn it. No, we want to turn it the other way. One more maybe, like that. So it sort of looks like it's out the end of it, but not quite worked right. I think we're going to have to lower a bit more of the ground. I don't think that's going to be in the right place. I think we're going to have to move it. Yeah. Oh, actually, no, that might work well, because let's have a look. If we could do that, but move it back just a little bit, undo that one, come in, drop down a little bit. If we can move that back a bit, and put it, we can sort of push it into the wall a bit. It's going to make the wall look like it's broken a bit, which could actually work out quite well in our favor, I think. If I can drop that one there, it's going to damage the last bit of the wall that we put in, and it's going to damage, it's going to have the broken, oh yes, yes, look at that. So it's actually, right, okay, we can save that one. That one can stay exactly as it is. So now we've got this, the end of the wall is sort of broken and deteriorated, fallen down. And then you've got the odd broken bits of tiles around the edges here. And plus these bits here dug in. That's actually looking really good. I like this. Come on, climb up. Let's have a look. And then you've got a bit of wall here. Come on, up you go. Oh, yes, I'm liking this. I am loving this. This is perfect. Right, come along the wall. And along this wall. Yes, this is all good. This side isn't brilliant because sort of blended in, but again, it looks like it's deteriorating. It looks like it's broken a little bit. Ooh, I know what we can do. Oh, yes, I got a brilliant idea. We are going to use our dragon to assist us with some construction work. Come on, dragon. Now, I've had a suggestion to call the dragon Spike, and I got to be honest, I'm not sure, because I don't feel like he's a spike. So I'd like some other suggestions of what we could call him, and I'm thinking it needs to be something dragonishly epic. And you know that dragons in old stories only have really truly epic names, so I'd like some more suggestions. See what you guys can come up with. See if you can come up with anything particularly cool, but it does have to be good. Right, we blast out the side there, and we'll do a bit more off the top of that one there. Thank you, dragon. That is excellent. Your assistance has been noted. So we're going to fly you over here, and you can go and terrorize the natives over there. We're going to carry on with our building. Come here, you. You leave my dragon alone. How dare you? I can't believe he's doing that. Don't make me hit the dragon, because then he'll get angry. Got ya. Ha ha! Right. Okay, looks like we are going to have to defend the dragon today, but I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. Right, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to try and do the belly flop. Up, up, and down. Yes! Ah! Ow! Oh, why do they do that? Up, up, and belly flop. Yes! Brilliant. Two in one. Okay, we're going to do that again. Up, up, and belly flop! And again, go on, you can do it, you can do it! Oh, yes! Epic. Epic finish. Right, I believe we were doing some work before we got momentarily distracted there. Right, we have another one over here. Okay, I'm going to find a weapon. Weapon. Sword. Ow! Give me a chance, I say. That was poor show, poor show. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Ha ha! Unsportsmanlike conduct, unacceptable on the field of battle. Right. Let's, yes, okay. That's not doing anything else. Chop the grass. Let's cut the grass. Cut the grass. There you go, old chap. Right. I was building, wasn't I? Yes. Now, we've done the tower there. Do I need to do another ruin tower? Because we've got the ruin tower. We've got Brickhenge. What else we got? I could always do a cottage and then demolish most of it. Use the dragon again. Would that fit in? That might, actually. We could do the cottage. If we do the cottage... Let's have this one. And we'll put this one over here, sort of on the hillside. It'll sort of just be... I think we could put that one down here. If we could put that in there... No, I want it a bit closer. I want it a bit sort of... Where are we going to put it? I know, on the edge here. If it goes on the edge here, it'll fill up the bottom bit there, I hope, if all goes well. Yes. All right, it's going to dig it out a little bit, but that's okay, because we need to turn this into a ruin now. And the way we do that, I think we'll get our dragon back to assist us with our building work. So, let's go and get him back. Where is he? Let's just summon in another one. We can have more than one dragon. That's okay. So, we need to do a bit more delicate building work with our dragon. Blast the roof. Go on. Oh, yes. Now, that is how you do building work. I'm really good at this building. Oh, brilliant. Yep. Okay. I could get used to this. What are you doing? Up there. No, you silly dragon. That bit. No, he's not going to do that bit. I might have to do that myself. Come over here. If you come back from here, can you do it? That's better. Take that bit out as well. Yes. I need to remove all of the roof, but I want to try, if I can, and leave a lot of the chimney. Because the chimney is often a bit that gets left behind when a building sort of collapses. Because that's always the thickest and the strongest part. Just because of the way that it's built. That happens in any building, in any old building. You find the fireplace is the only bit left. We don't want the bit that looks like a modern kitchen, because this has got to look old. It's got to look old-fashioned. So we do have to remove quite a bit here. Alright, let's remove... Okay, so we haven't actually got much left now. We got a bit of a fireplace. Let's take that bit out over there. And that one. Going to come out? Yes. Down there. Got a bit of a bookcase going on here, so I want to get rid of that. And can I get rid of that bit without spoiling the chimney? Ooh, I don't know what's going on there. Let's try it here. Okay, that's not working. We need to come over this way and do it. Fireballs going off. And I hope there's no one over there, because they're gonna get a really rude surprise. Right, that's perfect. We got a chimney left over there. Right, dragon, you come over this way. Thank you very much for your assistance. It was invaluable. Go and park you over here somewhere. Can blunder through a few of these. There you go. Go and play with that policeman over there. Right. Now, what are we going to build? Oh, yes. Pumpkins. That's a wheel. Okay. Never mind those. Now we want to sort of put in a few gravestones, I think. Because you've got an old ruined house there. It's like a smoking crater now, thanks to our dragon. And... I want to find the gravestones. Where are the gravestones? Down, 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 down. Down, 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 down. Oh, up, up. Yeah, what's... the signpost. The signpost could be useful. I'll tell you what would be really cool is if you could actually drive. Drive? Right. Drive? Why would you drive a signpost? What's the matter with me? Let's put that one just there. Just a signpost. A random signpost. It would be very cool if you could write on it. And then you could say, beware, or something like that. Beware! Ah, oh, that would be really cool. If you could get signposts to talk, then you could actually get them to say, beware. Right, we're going to put some graves here. I think we're going to put them in a nice, neat, orderly line. So it looks like it was once a kept graveyard. It's got to come out. Yeah, I'm leaving a gap of three in between each one, aren't I? So come out over here. There's another one. Right, so we got three gravestones. We got the gravestones in a line there. I'll try and get these another line of them lined up here. There we go. Perfect. Skip three. If I do that each time, and I'll move down through here, I'll do another line of gravestones. Like this. Something's gone wrong. Where have I gone wrong? Oh, I went wrong back there. Right, we'll have to remove those and try that again. So those are in place. Come down. And... right, first of all, I'll come over here. I've got too many skeletons running around. Let's get rid of you. Now these are going to come out. Ha ha! Oh, yes! This sword is epic! I'm loving this. Right. Remove these gravestones. I've got three of them to take out. There. Nope, too many. I have to take it out now. And I need to put those back. So let's get those gravestones again. Oh, we've got to scroll down through. So right down, right down. Almost there, that one. So I'll put in these lines here. 1, 2, 3. And then 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And finally 1, 2, 3. There. So I've got two neat and tidy orderly lines of gravestones. And now I'm going to put a bit of a ruined fence going on. Did I get any other fence, or is it just this ruined one? That... oh, no, we want to bring that one out this side, don't we? So we want to go... yeah, we want to go over here. And that will go in front of the wall, so it can go there. But now I want a more of a ruined wall. Have we got just a line of spikes? Poor show... creeping up on me like that when I wasn't expecting it. But I do have a sword. So I got those spikes. I thought I had another line of spikes. I thought I had some different spikes that I could use. Do we have any spikes in like the normal building stuff? I don't think we do. I don't think we got anything like that. Unfortunately. That's a shame. No, we really don't, do we? How are we going to do this then? This could be... this is a head scratcher. A head scratcher and a puzzle. Let's just have a look down through carefully, see what we got. What can we use? So we got a cauldron up there. And what is this? Oh, it's a tree. Right, it's just not showing up there. We can't see the picture. We've got flower beds, barbecues, they're no good. I want a line of spikes. A better line of spikes than that, because that's just a broken one. So we may have to use that one and sort of improvise on it a little bit. And I'm pretty sure I know how we can do that. We can sort of chop and we can have to spin them round, do them back, front, and front to back, if you see what I mean. Because graveyards do need the iron spikes. Yeah, we're going to have to do that. We're going to have to turn it round. So where were we? There we are. So if we bring that one over there, we can come out. I need to keep it in line. So that one will go there, like that. And then if we turn it round that way... do the same again. So I need to make sure that I keep it in line. Oh, don't jump around. You were doing so well. There. Right, how's that? Oh, no! They're all floating. Are they all floating? Why are they floating? Right, we're going to have to get rid of those. Right. Sword! Here we go. I'm not happy with this. Get rid of those. Now, there we go. And the last lot. We don't want floating stuff. It cannot float. It's got to be down on the ground so that it looks proper, epically cool and scary. See, the gravestones, they're all onto the ground. So let's try this again. And what do we want? We want the props. Now we want the spiky fence. We'll try this once more with the spiky fence. If it doesn't work, we'll have to try something a little bit different. Maybe if we put the spiky fence this way around... and if I come down low to the ground, if I can I see where it's going to go into the ground? Oh, what's it doing now? It like I said, it's a bit buggy. It is an early access game. But once we get used to how it sort of works... right, that's floating. How can I stop it from floating? Well, I'll tell you what. We come over here and then we can play around with it a bit. And we can see what it does. You got a little thing here. I don't know what that actually does. Is that just showing you the direction that they can turn? Not sure. Let's try turning it. See if it... because it will blend it... oh yeah, you can blend them in together like that. But again, they're still floating. Look at that. There's a gap underneath them. And that's the bit that I don't like. Why is it floating up like that? What's the issue here? Because that seems like it's... then going into the ground. Maybe it's on the wrong height. I know what we can do. we can test this little theory. If we go to... What do we want to use? We need the terrain shaping tools. And we want flatten. Yeah, flatten. Right. If I do flatten, that will flatten it down to there. So if I bring that up a little bit. There we go. I want to get it to flatten to that height, but it's not going to. Why won't you flatten to that height? Well, it will flatten to that height, so I can raise it up, and then we can test it to see if it's being raised up enough. Now what's it doing? That's lowering down. That? Okay, now we got some floating and some not floating. Not really sure what's going on here. Now it's dropping down. Okay, that's really bizarre, because we moved this around, it pushed it down into the ground. So maybe we just need to work, maybe we need to do that a little bit. Let's push those back over there. And while we're here, we'll just smooth off that little bit over there. Stop the edge there, and then I want to smooth off a bit of the edge of this crater, because I think it's a little bit too drastic, where our dragon was blasting stuff. There we go. There, I think that looks a bit more realistic. Now, if we look over here, this appears now to have been dropped down where we wanted it. What's going on here? Oh, no, that's the smoothing. We didn't want that one. We want... let's flatten that bit. Flatten this bit over here. Yes. Right, so now it's pushed them down onto the ground. I don't know why it's doing that, but it is, so we can work around that. At least we know how we can work around it. So I'm going to get rid of these bits of wall a minute. Let's chop them down. Chop! Smash! Me smash! Ha ha! Ooh, I know what we could do for the me smash! Me smash! You good! Ha ha! Not him, though. We would want someone, and then we can use the... Yeah, we're going to have to push those down a bit, I think. Come here. Come here, you! Come here! Ha ha! Oh, I'm loving this sword. This sword is epic. It's brilliant. Yeah, we get like the caveman or someone with that troll club. That troll club is pretty cool. I do like that one. Hi. How you doing? There you go. Have some of that one. Flatten again. So we do... If we flatten, is it going to work? Ah. Problem. I can flatten over there, but if I put the flatten over it, it doesn't actually move it unless I can move the ground first. Ooh. Oh, I know what we can do. I know. Raise terrain. So if I do that, and just spike it under it like that, then I go back, and then I go to flatten, is that going to work? Is that going to bring up the terrain? Or more importantly, is it going to level that down? Yes! Yes! It's worked! Right, so we figured that one out. Now I just got to add a whole load of fences in, and then I can go along and I can level them all out. So let's do that a minute. Where's the props? There we go. Right, we want that iron spike railing, because that's what we need around a graveyard. Now come over here. Join it up. I'm going to join in a couple of them. Move over. I just want you to move over one. Just one there. That one. That one. No! Oh, not again. We do seem to have a few issues with this all lining up exactly as it should, but maybe that's because it just dropped down. Not really sure. I know, I'll turn it round. Let's just turn it round first, and we'll give it a chance like that. Right, well, there's... Now it's working. I had it! There! Yes! No! Oh! Oh, so close! Alright, we'll do it out there, and we'll just have to pretend that was a gateway. Yeah, it won't go any further than that. It doesn't seem to like the idea of coming in here any further than that. Maybe if I could turn it round again. Ooh, there's something... I don't know if there's something there. There's something about that bit in particular it doesn't seem to like. So let's come over here. And I'm going to build a little bit more of this. I'll finish building this railing around here. And then we can have a look at the final sort of... the finished product. I managed to put some of them down. But I didn't manage to put all of them down. I think it's sort of bugging itself a little bit because we put We already put some down there, didn't we? And then we took them up and we tried to put them down again. It might be that, or it might be the fact that we got stone under here. I don't know. Because those, I managed to get those lined up perfectly without any trouble whatsoever. So I'm going to have a little play around with that between this episode and the next one. And I think we will carry on with our building on the next episode, although I'm not going to guarantee it. I might want to do a little bit more exploring, because I've been trying to do this building for a couple of episodes now. We are starting to do a little bit of building. It is starting to look alright. Come out of the way. Right, I'm going to leave those skeletons alone. I'm not going to fight them now, because I am really running out of time. I've gone way over time on this. I got sort of stuck into it and started to really enjoy it. I hope you did too. This is Frithgar, and are we going to do it next time? I really don't know. I'll tell you at the start of the next episode if we're going exploring again or if we're going to do some more building. So, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Goodbye, and see you later.